Hi everyone, welcome to reallife.com. I'm your host and personal trainer Manoj Sarangapani from Lynx Gymnasium. And we are going to talk about how to lose belly fat today. There is a common saying called there is nothing like spot reduction, which is true to an extent. Although I'm going to delve into certain aspects which will help you lose fat. That includes your nutrition, your workout intensity and your cardio as well. And when I say nutrition, we are talking about your macronutrients and your micronutrients. Macronutrients as in your protein intake, your carbohydrate intake and your fat intake as well. Yes, fats are important. So let's talk about nutrition first. I personally have seen people who have been in this fitness industry, who have been working out, who have been new and who have been working out for quite a few years now, but they are clueless about their nutrition. When I talk to them, they say that, sir, we are doing everything possible. We have cut down on our carbohydrates. We don't eat our rice. We don't eat potatoes. We don't eat outside. But we are still not losing fat. What should we do? I say stop right there. Are you eating as per the requirements of your body? I don't think so. You don't need to cut down on everything at one go. No need to stop your rice. No need to stop enjoying some junk food. Have it occasionally. I say let's produce some sustainable results. Look into what you're eating. Is it having enough protein? Is it having enough omega-3s and 9s from your fats? Is it having carbohydrates? In a day, aim to at least consume 1 gram of protein per pound of your body weight and simultaneously bring down the calorie intake from your carbohydrates and your fats as well. Another myth in the fitness arena is we lose belly fat, we lose fat overall only by doing crunches, leg raises and all other stuff related to a fat. But no, it's not the case. You lose your fat even by doing weight training. So now let's talk about certain exercises for your core. Beat whatever exercises that you're performing. It has always to be in strict form. Be it your leg raises, be it your crunches, sit-ups, reverse crunches, oblique crunches or ball crunches, whatever it is. It has to be always in strict form. You should feel each and every rep. Do 15, do 20 reps, do 25 reps or do even less reps. Not a problem. You will increase it in a period of time. But still perform it in very strict form. So here I'm going to demonstrate hanging reverse crunches. The other exercise that I'm going to demonstrate today is the normal sit-ups. While doing a sit-up, always make it a point to keep your feet closer to your butt. Don't move it away. So coming over to cardio now, it's not important that you come to a gym and hop onto the treadmill to perform your cardio. You can always enjoy a brisk walk or a jog near your place. You can go cycling, you can go hiking, whatever it is, you can always enjoy it, make it enjoyable. According to the ACE guideline, that is American Council on Exercise, a 10 minute to 15 minute walk in moderate intensity is more than enough. Thrice a week, do it, it improves your blood circulation, it improves your breathing capacity, it improves your metabolism as well. So that's it for today guys. If you really enjoyed our video, do like, comment and subscribe to our channel and enjoy more videos soon to be updated.